Hello there, UK EDCers. Today we're reviewing this, which is the Viper Dan 2. The Dan 1 being the same thing, but instead of a Warncliffe style blade, it's got a clip point. This I purchased, surprisingly, from Heinie Haynes again. This one was £129 and change, basically. I'll throw up the store page again, and a link will, as always, be in the description. It will be available at other places. So you can get this in a variety of flavours. You can get this in, like, obviously you can get it in Clip Point and Warncliffe, Dan 1 and the Dan 2. Dan standing for Daily Assorted Needs, of course. You can get sort of like a silver twill carbon fibre, a micarta, wood, G10. Pretty much, you want it, this knife offers it, which is fantastic, obviously. So, box. Yeah, it's a thing. It's certainly not boring. Looks the part. Guess Italians have a flair for style, so they say. Inside, literally all you get is the knife baggie that it comes in. And you get this, which is like a little info piece. If it wants to focus there. Congratulations on owning a Viper knife. This knife is recognised by the Minaggio quality system. I get the Fox knives was from Adam Minaggio thingamabob, whatever it is. So you got steel types there, you got blade hardness, you got bolsters, scales and handles, lovely. All kinds. Guidelines for use, care and maintenance. Precautions and injury. Disposal. I mean, come on, who's throwing that away? And last, and most importantly on this card, you have your warranty. And they have a limited lifetime warranty, although it doesn't cover normal wear. Also, failure to perform maintenance. I don't know how they prove that, but that will also void your warranty, so... Talking of maintenance, this knife... Oh my goodness, taking this thing apart is an absolute ball ache. You would not believe how difficult it is to get this thing apart properly. So basically, you've got a T8 for your pivot on that side and that side. And then you've got T6 all along here, T6 for those three, T6 for those three. You've got another three holding the inner liner onto this backspacer. But wait, there's more. Now you need a spanner on this side and a spanner on this side because these screw into the actual pivot. The pivot is under here. So the pivot is, I've never seen anything like it. It's an odd proprietary thing. It's quite smart, to be honest. I've got a picture of me having taken this all apart. Basically, you've got like a bit here that screws into a bit here with a hole through the middle in which these both screw into. It is such a pain to get that out because this has very much like this boy has a detent ball mechanism. So there's no back spring or anything like that. It's literally completely hollow. It's just a detent ball in this side on the liner and a detent ball in this side of the liner. Another reason this is a pain in the ass to take apart is those detent balls, they're not captive. As soon as you take this apart, those detent balls will just fly out and go everywhere. Ooh. Had fun finding those. So, yeah. There's a fair bit of hardware on this. You've got a total of, 3, 6, 9, 11, T6, 2 T8, whoopsie. And then the weird spannery proprietary. I mean, it doesn't require a proprietary tool. I'm sure they offer one, though. Either way, it's not a piece of cake to get in. So, the action on this is a lot more firm than something like this, say. Now, they're both exactly the same mechanism, whereas this one, you can just fling open like that. No chance with this one. Hell, this doesn't even have a nail nick, which I like. This one is sort of like a slow-mo... I guess, what do they call that? Like a back flipper? Ugh. I love it. I think it's fantastic, that action. It's just stiff enough to keep it slow so that when you get this out and use it, it's discreet and non-aggressive. There's no flashy flicking or anything like that. It's just a very nice, smooth action. Slow, methodical, deliberate. And when you put it away, you just knock it into there and then just close it with your finger. This action was basically made for me. I love it. It takes a bit of getting used to, don't get me wrong. Like when you start, you'll be like taking it to there and then trying to finish it off like that, trying to figure it out. But once you get that thumb maneuver down, just it's a breeze. It's absolutely beautiful. The washers on this, as you'll see in that picture, are the teeniest, tiniest little phosphor bronze washers you'll ever see on any knife ever. I think a close competitor is the XM Slippy. The pivot sort of, it isn't captive, but it is. Because of the way the spanner head, or the head of the pivot interacts with the arm of the detent ball, it sort of does hold it captive a little bit. So you shouldn't really have too many issues. I mean, you definitely won't have any issues taking it apart, at least at the Torx level. I don't know if I could say the same for the actual spanner bit, but yeah, that's his own thing. That's Felix. Scales on this. Mine are carbon fiber. As I mentioned at the beginning, you can pretty much get this in any flavour you want. I would have got this in, I think it was a burgundy micarta. I mean, I did prefer the look of this one, but I don't have a micarta knife, so it would have been nice, but sadly, that was a limited run and I missed out, so I don't think you can get micarta anymore.
Wrong.
But you can get G10, you can get wood when it's available. So, carbon fibre, you can get a silver twill carbon fibre, which reviews on Heine's website say looks better in their pictures than it does when you actually get the knife. It looks darker in real life. I'm sure there's a review of the silver twill. I purposely avoided it because in the pictures it's basically white carbon fibre or silver carbon fibre. That's too flashy for my workplace. I don't particularly want a bright, shiny look at me knife at work. This one's elegant but not in your face. This one does allow you to have a lanyard. You've got your little hole there that goes through the clip as well, all the way through. Talking of that clip, the clip is on point. It is a deep carry, reversible. Just unscrew these, flip it over, and you can absolutely put it on whichever side you'd work like. There is a little bit of billboarding on this if it wants to. I guess we'll get it that way around. I actually think that's very tasteful. I really don't mind that at all. It's sort of, I guess, like you'd find on the inside of a sports car, like the door or something. Just a nice little design, decent font, nothing crazy or wacky like the zero tolerance style. Nothing weird like, you know, the old Manly brand. Like, yikes, that's an odd one. I think this is very elegant. I like this so much, in fact, that as you saw with that one, as you've seen with this one, when they're silver, I usually like to blacken them, just again to make it less obvious in my pocket. Not so with this one, I can't do it. It's just, I like the look of it too much as is. So yeah, I've just left that stock. The liners in this go all the way through, as again you'll see in that disassembly picture. They're basically just attached to this backspacer and that pivot there, that's all. But yeah, they do support, which is nice because carbon fiber does have a habit of sort of fraying, if you will, over time. grip on this bad boy. You have a very nice little space for your index finger to go there. And then your middle fingers and your, whatever, your ring finger, pinky, all sit nicely along here, just like that. And that's beautiful. And you still got a little bit of the end here. Your thumb falls very nicely onto this chimping here, which also acts as a nice bit of control to stop the blade closing. They really thought about everything on here. Trust me, this is one of, if not the most ergonomic knife I've ever held. It's unreal how well this fits into your hand. This, even with this sort of aggressive upsweep of the clip there, is not a hotspot, trust me. That's like, there's no hotspot there whatsoever. They've really, really put some effort into designing this thing properly, from the looks to the ergonomics. This isn't too difficult to close. This is, you can close it with two hands if you want. But again, it's designed to be opened with one hand, it's designed to be held open with your thumb, and it's designed to be closed with one hand. Exactly my preference. Some of you may dislike that. Some of you may prefer like a strong lock up, although again, your thumb's there, so there is no safety with which to speak of if it does go. I suppose there is that little bit there. I lie. There's a tiny bit there which your finger will fall into before this will start really chomping into your finger. But I take that back. There's a little. And the fit and finish on this thing, honestly, the centering is a teeny tiny bit off, but that could have been me pissing around with it. I wish I'd taken a picture of this and checked the centering before I'd taken it apart. I'm sure that was my fault. However, good grief, this thing is pretty. I haven't a bad thing to say about any of it. It all fits together perfectly. There were no dripping screw issues. All the screws, even though they were Loctite blued, they all came out flawlessly, no issues. That thing in here was a little bit of an issue, but again, it's supposed to be, I guess. This backspacer is wonderful, like a titanium there, anodized. Oh man, yeah, I love it. This comes in N690, at least mine does. I don't know if everyone's does, but there we go, N690. Which I'm told by the internet is a mid-range deal. I can't find anything wrong with it at all. It holds an incredibly decent edge. I've been using this all day at work today, and I can't see a single bit on this edge where it's notably dull. I mean, I've barely had to sharpen this. I've had this for about a month now as well, carrying it on and off, and it's supremely nice, this steel. It's easy enough to sharpen, and it just doesn't seem to blunt. I did have one issue where I lent this to a co-worker who then proceeded to do the casual bit of cardboard slam into the fucking metal surface. Air through teeth, and then, I guess I had to sharpen that shit. But it just sharpened quite nicely. I don't think I fucked up the edge at all. You got a nice belly on there. I love this. It's got a flat grind, your Warncliffe style. You do have a little bit of a swedge on the other side, as for billboarding. I guess you want it that way, don't you? You've just got a very elegant little Dantu. The Viper logo with Viper, and then made in Maniago, Italy. How elegant is that? Just nice, simple, that's it. Scuffs. You may be able to see here a little bit of scuffing. It's not easy to see, but it does pick up scuffs. That's all from just cutting through cardboard, sticky tape, all that kind of stuff. And there are a couple of little nicks just going up the blade there. Not really sure what caused that, but It's nothing too crazy. Size of this knife. Okay, so. It weighs 95 grams. It is a tad heavy. It's not annoying, but I guess, you know, it's there. It does feel good in the hand, though. It's really still not heavy. Like, it's less than 100 grams still for the whole thing. You have a thickness of 0.3 centimeters at its thickest point on the blade there. The length is, you have a 7.3 centimeter edge and an overall length of 18.2. Again, we'll do the usual compare. Standard Spyderco there. UK PK. We got the Manly Wasp. You can see it's right alongside these with a slightly longer handle. It sort of occurred to me that a few of you might have this. CRKT Leongma number 5. Yeah, it's a little bit bigger than that, although not taller. And for the Americans out, the standard Benchmade 940. The Rat 1. And I thought, hell, I'd include the Recon 1 here as well. I sort of don't like this review because I don't really feel a review's good if you've not said anything negative. I'm struggling so hard to find anything negative about this knife though. The price maybe, £128. But you are getting carbon fiber, you are getting phosphor bronze, you are getting liners throughout the whole thing, you are getting a sublime action, you are getting a limited lifetime warranty. Viper's a fairly well-known company. It's Italian made. I think it looks absolutely gorgeous. Like, even clothes like that. I mean, I just cannot fault this knife. I stopped short of it saying it's perfect. It's just below the legal limit. 7.4, this is 7.3 blade edge. The blade comes all the way up to the handle, so you've got the maximum amount. It slices great, there's nothing in the way, and yet it's still one hand opening, which I, as you may well know by now, adore. It's a smooth enough action, there's nothing wrong with that. It's perfectly non-aggressive. The Warncliffe style lends itself well to cutting things in that kind of manner. I hate it. I hate not being able to say anything negative. I suppose the thing I would say the most that's negative is that satin finish is easily ruined by just cutting through cardboard. But I really am struggling to say negative things about this.
Okay, so I was waffling here, so I'm just going to concise this and make a proper point. Basically, the only really bad things I can say about this would be the proprietary pivot is a massive pain in the ass to take apart, with the limited warranty that can be voided if you don't do proper maintenance, cleaning out dust and particles and oiling your washers every so often. That's sort of proper maintenance to me. So yeah, that pivot being a bit weird, that's a negative. The choil, sharpening choil, you'll notice that scales stick out a little bit in sort of like a point over the blade, sort of rendering that sharpening choil utterly, utterly useless. So there's that as well. Minor points, but they are still very much there.
I mean, this is a thing of beauty. This is a very, very nice knife. I'm really, really happy with the Dan. Tell you what, the name. Why did they have to call it Dan? Okay, cheers all. Thanks for watching.